He called me, he has some
So Arul is not joining today?
No, no, he will join. He will join me.
Okay, we'll start the training today.
Yes, yes, please. Yes, start the training. We will join.
If he's coming in another 4 or 5 minutes, we'll wait.
Yes, I'll check with him. Yes,
we can
start on
our giant. Okay. Yeah. So, brother, we'll continue with the setup things or what?
Yeah, you explained to him what is the overall folder structure, how it is configured, those kind of things. Services where we define. You both brief us and you explain the database structure also, wherever, what is our format, as well as how to add a new scripts, those kind of things, tenants. We discuss all these points today. And then how to do anywhere local setup, we don't take much time. Okay? Thank you.
Okay, first I will explain about the setup and things, local workspace setup, and then so next, and then what are the naming conventions, the how to add the script, those kind of things. Okay, so first you have to, so that's what you have to clone these two repo. One is DC service or client, anyone. Okay, client only going to work mostly, so with you. So it is the same thing only. So workspace service, same thing only for all these two things. Okay. So only the client, and you create in the client repo. So inside that is a, you have to create like this one more project. Okay. Ego DCF client IMPL. So we have sample already. So this is a sample. Okay. So if you check out like normally it will come. So if you want, you can rename also, that's no issue. So if you keep this name, you can, it will be easy to. So in that client level, you need to this under this ego client IMPL project level. So you need to add your whatever going to customize those things. Okay. So what are the features you're going to. So I already explained how to do these things. Okay.
Yes,
so
yes.
Just add a new feature here. Okay. So our procedure for adding new feature is just add, okay, an existing whatever is there, but you need to use that same name only. Okay. So for that reference, you can use that plan feature repository, or you can refer the ego DCS service level. Okay. What are the features we have? Okay. So there you need to use the same name only, you need to. So when you want to extend that override or so with a particular state name or city name, you have to use the same name which available in the master. Okay, whenever we are adding new. So first entry is when you want to add new feature means you have to add here. Okay. So create just one, create one class, for example. Okay, before that I will first I'll explain the this thing, later I will. So just to clone it, these things, okay. So once you say clone, then just import it your repository. So just import with the existing Maven project, okay. You have to select existing Maven project, it's a Maven project. Yes. Okay, so then your check your clone location. Okay, go to your clone location and then select. So this ego. Just select, and then just click. Okay, so it will show what is not imported. It will show. Okay, it will then finish. So it will import into your local workspace. Okay, once you load, and then it will go with the Maven update. So once it will import, so it will some take some time. Okay, so next thing is, so go to your window preferences. Okay, so there we need to point out the settings.xml file. Okay, so when you import clone, this is the folder structure. Okay, so we have the one is a build folder, one more is a hero folder. Okay, so in this build folder, so it's a build related things. So it is under ego. Okay, so these are the modules which is available. Okay, common config, edcr, edcr web, eg, egm. okay, so and then pom.txt, and one more we have the settings.xml. okay, so it is a settings.xml is ego nexus repo. So this settings.xml you need to point out in the map, okay, in the Eclipse shell. So why you need to point out means, so few libraries is not available in the Maven central, okay, in Maven repo, central repo. So few libraries is not available, like a dynamic Jasper libraries is not available. Okay, so that is available only in a ego nexus repo. Okay, so that's why, so go to your window preferences. So then go to the user setting. So here, that user setting, you point out your settings.xml file. Okay. Okay, so just close and point to the settings.xml file, and then just apply close. Okay. This is one additional thing. Things. So it is, there is only to point out our ego, that ego nexus repo. So that dynamic Jasper is not available in a Maven center. That's why this additional settings. So other than no use, only for the purpose only this is point out. That one thing. No. Okay, once you're done, so your this import is done. Next is you need to add your server. Okay. So suppose you, so here, so here suppose if you don't have not showing a server means, just go to this quick that window show view. So they from there you can select this view. Okay, so this server, when you click on that, it will show here. Okay, so just we click on the, So when you click on the server tab, it will show this one. Okay, no servers available. Click here thing to create new server. Okay, so then you have to select this one. Okay, so Wi-Fi 11. So definitely initially that Jeba, I mean Eclipse, you may not find this one. Okay, Wi-Fi server. So for that you need to install JBoss tools. So you need to install JBoss tool. For that, go to Eclipse Marketplace.
Yes, already we have installed the
JBoss
tools.
You have installed, no? Okay.
Yes.
So just go to Eclipse Marketplace and then search the JBoss. Okay. So the tools it will show. So just click on that, it install. So this one, JBoss tool 4.1.1. Okay, 4.1.13.0. Okay. So it's in machine already installed. Okay, if you are not installed, just install it. So then restart your Eclipse. Okay, so then this Wi-Fi it will show you. Okay, so select 11. Okay, Wi-Fi 11 you select. So here it will come new in. So just browse to your So you already downloaded the Wi-Fi, okay, from there.
Yes.
Okay, just download and then point to that home directory, okay, Wi-Fi 11, the home directory. Okay, just point to and then add this one, okay, this one is ego ERP this here. So that ER you add it. So this is for a master, this is for a client IMP, okay. So ego EDCR IMP. So I added the client IMP only. Okay, so once you've done this one, and one more you have to do. So right click on that, click open. So here open launch configuration is here. Okay. So here you need to increase your heap memory. So default is a minimum is a 64 MB. Okay, so you can keep 512 MB. So you can keep is a depends on your memory. 2G. So minimum is 512 MB and then maximum is a 2 GB. So if you want to buy, if you have 16 GB like that, you can keep 1 GB, 2 GB or 3 GB also, that's fine. So if you want update this one, you will get the timeout exception, okay. So it is around it is required memory. So then you won't spootness, you are not able to spootness, okay. If you don't increase this, suppose if you are getting timeout exceptions or if you are not able to spootness any plan, then you need to check this one. Okay, open launch configuration. You need to increase that memory. Okay, this heap memory you need to increase. So then it will work. Okay. So this only then that's it. Okay. Suppose if you want to change the port, you can change this one. Okay. So in which port you want to run, then you can change here. Okay. So here, the web port is here, no? So here you can change it to your, so default 8080, it will run on 8080, so you can change it with any as you wish. Okay, so sometimes I may not deploy properly, so those cases you need to just do the workspace clean. Okay, so just go to the project and clean it. So first time you just do suppose if you sometimes you may not deploy, like it's not, if you are not deploying means you will get 404. Okay, even the server is up but still your application is not up. Okay, so at the time you have to try with this project clean, that one. So if the project is ER is not built properly, then you will get. So if you have any maven issue, like any issue of those can also, it may not deploy properly, so at the time just you need to fix that one. So that's it. So there's one thing, and this is the server clean things. So sometimes, if you're not, means you can deploy the delete this one, okay, and then this data log temp folder. Again, you need to do the rebuild. If you are facing any issue with, like a deployment issue, so those cases you can delete the data log and temp, these folders, and then inside this here delete it and then build probe freshly and then start your server. Okay, so this one thing, and before that, and one more is you need to run in the Redis server should run look okay parallelly before you start in the Wildfire server. So you need to make sure that Redis server is up. Okay, so in a Ubuntu machine default Redis server it will be there. Okay, so it will be running only defaulty. So in the, if it is Windows machine, you need to start it manually. Okay, Redis server issue for caching purpose. Okay, to catch the that city information.
Redis is mandatory, right?
Yeah, it's a mandatory.
So we can't put any
plans. Yeah. It's a mandatory. So it's our catching purpose we are using. So city information, those session, those kind of information we're keeping in a Redis only.
Okay.
So it won't
be if we have any external Redis server where we need to configure the Redis properties.
Mm. Yeah, that's sure I will mention. So once you this up, I will update you.
Okay.
So just it, so once you done this, it will stop. So now the Wildfire server is up. So how to changing this one? Okay, Redis server default URL, those kind of things. So there actually in the setup level you have, okay, what is the property name of those things. So if you go to the EDCR service readme document, so here okay, this is the first thing. Okay, Redis enable embedded should be false. Okay, true default it is true. Okay, so in the production environment or in a UAT environment, if the Redis service is running a different server, okay, if you're maintaining two servers, one is for an app server, one is for a Apache Redis or those kind of for those. Okay, so those cases you need to make Redis enable is embedded false. Okay, so suppose if everything is running, Redis server also running in the same server which app server is running, okay, this Wildfire server running, so at that time you can keep embedded is true. Okay, if suppose you're running in a different machine, okay, then you need to make it false. So then you need to give the host name, okay, that server Redis server host name you need to give, and then on the which port it was running.
Okay,
so here you need to mention that port and host name if the Redis server is running in a different machine. Okay, so this one you can default is available in this. Okay, so okay. Default setting available in a application config that properties you can override two places you can override now. Okay, one is in a while server in a Wildfire server we have ego ERP override properties.
Okay,
so that one is available. So under the Wildfire and then modules system layers base and then org, and ego settings main config. Okay, so you can configure over here. Okay, those you can override. Okay, the default whatever the properties is there we are configured. So here you can, so in this override properties level, okay, you can configure it. We can override the values. Okay, here. So here you can configure your, okay. So if you want to show, see the default things. So this is okay. Default is this is okay. So which code is running and then host name. Both things. So this is a default port only, 6379 is a default port. So this is for the overriding the securities. So server is up now, it's validating. Gumanana. Sorry. So once you server up, you need to use the, okay. This is, okay, this is for setting the Redis information. Okay. And then, so what are different setting we have means? So and one more, we have is a dev mode true or false. Like a development purpose, you can make it a dev mode true, defaultly true. So in case of UAT and production environments, you can make it false. Okay. So why is it dev mode nothing but it's a development mode.
Yes, what is the difference?
So, yeah,
if
I
dev mode is false, means what is the difference between dev mode true and false?
So, if dev mode true enables, so we have sample scripts.
Okay.
Okay, database script, we have sample. Okay, sample users information is available. So, they, okay. Those are we are putting under sample. Okay, so okay. For example,
the sample data is
under
inserted into database, otherwise
sample data under it will insert. Yes. Yeah, so this sample under whatever is under this folder sample. So those things it will run when dev mode is true. If it is false, it won't execute these scripts.
Okay,
so this is only for a development purpose, local development, the default data, those kind of things we are putting in the sample. Okay, so across, you know, which are common, those DDL, DML, those kind of thing we are putting under main. So common data like a default users, those kind of things we are putting in the sample.
Okay.
So you can use the dev mode true, that all that one thing you can use. And one more, we have like this master server. Okay. So suppose if you are configuring a UAT production 2-3 servers. Okay. So in that case, you need to keep one server is a master server, and remaining you need to make as a false. Okay. So like we have two databases. One is a read-write database, and one more we have is a read database. Okay. So that master server you make enable true, master server true. So at the time, the read-write operation will perform in a master server only. Okay. And the read-only operations and all will happen in a slave servers. Okay, if you are configuring two servers, one is master, one is slave, So at the time that is, so it will performance will be increased. Okay. So read write only will happen in a master server, and then read operations and all will happen in a slave server. It won't, the read operation won't happen in a master server. So this master server too, that you can configure that thing. So this is for a build information though, things. This thing is not that bad. This SMS and all is not affected. Okay, no. And one more is this one. Multi-tenancy enable is true. Okay, so if you are so multi-tenancy true or false, you need to make. So if it is a multiple cities you are configuring, then you need to make should be true. Okay, if you only for a one city if you are configuring, then false. Okay, so if you're going for a multiple city, should be true. Default is true. Multi-tenancy true. Okay. So next is this one, tenant, how to set up in the tenant. Okay, these are the things. Okay, so this is a default one is a, so this is for a state URL. Okay, tenant dot, this is the actual URL. Okay, this is the, you need to get your okay domain, those thing you need to get for only for a state URL. Okay, so when you want to get domain everything, you need to get for the state URL only. Okay, so only based on the state URL only going to scrutinize those plans. Okay, just you're going to pass the tenant information like a which for which city you're going to tell. Okay, so here is a for across state one URL. Okay, so to handle to scrutinize for plans for a different city, you need to pass the city tenant ID. Okay, tenant ID nothing but your city ID, that city name. Okay, so that's why this one. So this is internal and one more, but you need to configure that each city for what is the URL. Okay, this is for a internal only. Okay, so for a city URL is internal URLs only. So for this and all, subdomain is not required. Pradeep?
For each city, we have to mention the domain name here, right? If I
It's a subdomain name.
City wise.
We need the subdomain.
Okay.
Yeah. So like this. Okay, you need to configure for each city. So this is a schema name. Okay, this is the schema name. Tiruvallur, Chennai, generic state is that.
Okay.
This is the schema name. So okay. So here.
That is state wise,
this is creating
current state e-governments org. You entered as a state, right?
Yeah.
But here we have Tamil Nadu.
So here you can use. Yeah, that's what you can keep the domain name. You can keep your niche.
Okay.
But yeah, this should be a state only. So the schema should be a state. You should not update as a Tamil Nadu here. Okay. It should be state only. The schema name, but URL you can keep as a Tamil Nadu ego dot or anything. Okay, ego.org, ego.in, anything you can keep. Okay, that schema, the main domain name is domain URL, but anything you keep, I mean, which you do for your, and you're going to get the domain, no? But that's here. So that URL you need to keep. Okay, so these are the subdomains. Okay. So you know, no need to get the subdomains from there. It's like a GoDaddy or somewhere. You need to get that license. Those things, only for you can get only for a state URL. That is enough. Okay. So this is only for external URL. It's going to expose only for this URL only. So these are the for internal purpose only. So it's a tenant base. Ours is a tenant base. Okay. For each city, we are creating one schema. So for the city infra, it will be persisting in that concern tenant. Okay. So like that, you need to configure something. Okay.
Okay.
So once you here one place you need to configure, and one more place, and database you need to update. So I will stop. So then start it. So these two schemas we're going to create. No, see for now for Chennai it's creating. So current schema is there is no schema. Now it's created the schema with Chennai. So in this Chennai schema, now the scripts are executing, it's running. Okay. So now Chennai schema is created. So that system, it will automatically create schemas, those kind of things. Okay, you can create manually also, no need. A system, if it is there, it will execute, it will take that, it will run there. Otherwise it will create new schema. So now it's created two schemas. Okay, one is for Chennai and one more is Tiruvallur. Okay. So now it's created. So then you need to go to the concern. State, okay, schema city table. Okay, now into this one. Okay, Chennai city. So here you need to update this domain URL. Okay, this domain URL you need to update with whatever you've given, that override property, whatever your domain name you've given, with the same unit. This is Chennai. Okay, so here you need to give that same domain name here. Okay, that one thing. Okay, database level, that schema, the concern city domain URL, and then whatever the for that schema, what domain URL is mapped, okay, in the tenant table, I mean the override property, that name should be same. Okay, the domain URL, subdomain URL should be the same. Okay, then only it will pick the concern city. So internally what happened? So internally when the scrutinize the plan, okay. So when the scrutinizing the plan here, okay. So you are going to pass the tenant ID as the Chennai, okay. Okay, so here, whatever name you are given with that name, okay, that ID only you're going to pass. So here that override properties level, whatever your schema name you pass, that name only you're going to pass as a tenant ID. Okay, Chennai Tiruvallur, this one. Okay, this name you need to pass. So internally what happened, it will the schema name, okay, with that schema name, so what URL is mapped it will take, okay. So it will give for this Chennai, this is the domain URL, okay, it will take this domain URL, in this with the domain URL it will query that database, okay. So then it will get that schema, that schema we are getting, and then that concern schema we are persisting the data, okay. So this is a way to configure the tenants,
okay. If the configuration is state wise, we no need to pass the tenant ID, or what we need to pass in the tenant ID.
So that's what you need to use. The URL is a state URL, okay.
Okay. Okay.
So when scrutinizing the plan, you need to pass the state URL.
Okay.
You're going to see here. Just a thing. Like I said, one set, one URL only. Okay. We don't have any for a external world. You're going to pass the only one exposing the this one URL. Okay. So like this.
Okay.
So tamilnadu.egovernments.org, okay, this is a your URL, okay.
No, I'm asking that if it is a state wise, tenant ID should be state or
state only.
What is the tenant ID? State only, right?
For state it's a state only tenant ID, but domain URL you can use is whatever you are getting, so that URL only, but schema name should be state only. Schema name, so data tenant that you need to pass a state only.
Okay.
Okay, so now I am passing the tenant ID to Chennai. Okay, now the plan is scrutinized.
Okay. In EDCR request, you are passing some JSON values, right? What are the details?
Yeah. I'll explain. So this is that response, okay, when you're scrutinizing a plan with that URL. So this is a output you are getting, okay. So that response info, these are that API ID, version, transaction, TS, response message ID, message ID, status, okay. So this you can set. So which API you are passing, from which API you are passing, those kind of things.
Okay.
I mean, these are empty only to come, so we are not setting anything. So it's a microservice standards, okay. If required, you can pass them, okay. For each API, some ID they define, okay.
Okay.
So we haven't done. So that API ID, version, everything they'll pass. Because multiple version is there, from which version, which API version is calling, you're getting response. When you maintain the versions for each APIs, so at that time, the information will come. Okay, this API ID, version, message, those kind of things. So as of now, it is empty only, it will come. Don't have anything. So this is the EDCR detail. Okay, so this is the your response. So here, the DXF, and whatever your uploaded file, that DXF name, it will come. Okay, then this is a plan, and then transaction number. So when you are scrutinizing, you need to pass your transaction number, okay. You have to create one transaction from your when you're passing that. So you maybe you having one application number, no, in your side,
yes.
Anyway, you're going to generate one application number, okay. So that transaction number you need to pass, yeah, that unique transaction you need to pass, okay, for each request. So then it will scrutinize, and then from our side also we are creating one application number. So status is aborted, okay. So here is a file is aborted, okay. So voice about maybe some city information is not getting them properly, so that's why. Okay, when you're setting internet, you need to update all the information. Okay, first one is the domain, you need to update with that one. Next is that city name, you need to configure with the name, and then next is your this local name is not mandatory, but you should update this district name. Okay, they should okay. District name should not be empty, that one thing, and the grade. You need to update with the US, okay? This district name, district code, those things. You need to update with the US district name and this whatever it is here. And next is okay, that's it. Only that much information is required. So sometimes may not available this data is not uploaded into update in a Redis, okay. So that may be possible chances. So that's why the district code is now name is not available. Okay. Now it's scrutinizing. So that's why that Redis server level, that whatever we update, you know, that state name, district name, those things is not got updated. So that's why I flashed the Redis. Okay. In your case, in the Windows machine, you need to restart your, stop it and restart the server. So at the time, it will freshly update with latest whatever data available in the database. So with that, it will update. So now it's updated. No, see, so this is the uploaded DXF file and then it's a updated DXF. So we are, as I explained, no, like we are marking where we are, minimum distance we are calculating, those kind of things we are marking in the DXF file.
Okay.
okay, that DXF file, that this one, this is the plan scrutiny report. Okay,
by hitting this URL we can download the report, right?
yeah. So this is a transaction number, it's not accepted, that's why unique number is not generated. So this plan PDF is just as of now, it's some dummy data only. Okay, it doesn't, so as of now it's a dummy only. Dummy is just we give these files only here also. So this is the plan info properties, okay, and plan info whatever is there, everything is available here.
Okay.
From there you can see. So these blocks and building floors, okay, you can see it. So it is extracted. It's mercantile commercial occupancy. Whatever it is. So this is the thing. Okay, so next I will explain about the request. Okay. So nothing is required, it's not required these things. Okay, so here you need to pass one more mandatory is the transaction number. Okay, transaction number is a mandatory, and then next user info is a mandatory.
Okay.
So this user info ID is nothing but who is scrutinizing. Like here, stakeholder, like billing licensing, that primary key ID you need to pass, or some unique number you need to pass, whatever your reason. So this is why later when you fetching that, so like so for example, architect one. So like consider as a Shivbalan is an architect. Okay. Now he is scrutinizing the some 5-6 plans. Okay. Now, so in the when the inbox loading, I need to get for so at the time you need to pass this ID for him. One ID you have created. Okay. In the system level, you have created one ID. Okay. User ID. Okay. To identify what are the transactions he have complete done. Okay. And then to fetch for the purpose only this user ID we are using. Okay, so that's why when you passing the request when scrutiny at the time you need to pass this transaction number and user ID. Okay, so it will saving in our system this user ID, user info ID. So again when you fetching that, you just pass, suppose if you want to get all means you no need to pass this user ID, it's not required. If you are found to fetch all the information, okay, irrespective of the any user, so at that time you can pass only the so there you have a different one. Okay, for a search request is a different one. So transaction number is optional there. Okay, or there also is this one only, but this is optional. Okay, you don't need to pass any info at the time, it will fetch all the data. So suppose if you want to fetch a particular data at the time, you have to pass the transaction number or EDCR number. So whatever is based on that, it will fetch and will give the response. Or if you want to fetch, so Shivbalan and what are the applications, what are the plans he is scrutinized. If you want to get the list, so at that time pass his ID. Okay, only his ID. Okay. So at that time for Shivbalan and what are the scrutinized the plan, all the plans it will get, it will show you in the response.
Okay.
So example. So you can pass the tenant ID or without tenant ID, you can pass. So it will look in all the tenants. Okay. Suppose we want to pay a particular tenant, then just pass the tenant ID also. Or if suppose if he working in a multiple cities, then just pass the. That user ID. No, nothing I passed. No, Okay. And one more is a tenant ID when you're passing that. One more. So when you're passing the tenant ID, you need to follow the some standard, okay? Like a TN. It's a tenant ID name is a TN, Tamil Nadu. Okay, what is the state name? So and then, so what is the city name? Okay. So this is a TN, your state name you're creating. Okay. Per state, this is a TN is a state name. Okay. And then another state, and the Chennai is a city name. Okay. Like that tenant ID when you're passing that you need to pass like this. Okay, this tenant how it system will identify means, so this TN is here, no? So this TN you need to update here. Okay, so in the database level in the state schema, okay, in the state schema, in the state city information, city code is here. Okay, so in the city code you need to update this TN. Okay, TN. So in the state city info available, the tag code you need to update that one, the state name, what is the state name, okay, to identify. So this why, because you want to fetch the data, all the plans which are scooters across the state or tenant wise, so at the time this is required. Okay, so why, because so here that's why the tenant ID is a mandatory. Okay, if you want to fetch across the cities for a particular stakeholder, okay, for a particular stakeholder, so at the time, so tenant ID you need to pass as a TN. So at the time it will look in across tenants. Okay, so across the cities it will look, so in all the cities what are the plans is scooters, it will get, it will show all the data. Okay, so that's why tenant ID is a mandatory. So here that's why tenant ID you need to pass like a TN dot Chennai, TN dot Tiruvallur, TN dot Trichy, like that you need to pass like that. Okay, tenant information. Okay, this TN is a, so we are configuring at the state city level. Okay, the state city information code, state city code should be this state name. Okay, you can use the big name or whatever. So for shorter only it will be fine. Any confusion or got it what I'm saying?
No, I got it.
Okay.
Scrutinizing the plan, no need to pass the state ID, but fetching the details, we need to pass the state, right?
No, the, at the time also you need to pass like a TN dot there only, there also.
Okay.
That I forgot. So here also in the tenant ID you're fetching, passing. So here also the tenant name should be this one only. Okay, TN dot Chennai.
Okay.
When scrutinizing also you need to pass like that only. I forgot to say here. Okay. So when scooting as well as fetching, all the time you need to pass tenant ID like this only. Okay. TN dot Chennai, TN dot Trichy, TN dot Tiruvallur, like that only you need to pass. So TN is a that Tamil Nadu state name. Okay. And that dot is a what is a city name. For which city you are, the plan is scrutinizing, that one information. And then so that for which user, so for which user going to school, for which user is a scrutinizing the plan. Okay, so there is nothing but your building license is here. Okay, architects, different architects you are registered in your system already. Okay, so yes. That user, that unique, some unique number you need to pass. It doesn't matter primary only, you can pass some UU code also for that user. If you're creating some unique code, that code also you can pass in the ID. to identify the what for which user the which user this plan is good, nice. Okay, to identify that, as well as because when in inbox you want to load, no, so at the time that ID is required, that's some unique info. Okay, for that user unique, some unique ID, something is required to fetch the those and then to load in this inbox. Okay, when login, so because you're going to provide a UIL, okay, in your machine. Okay, so there you need to show all the plans, the particular stakeholder, because he may scrutinize for multiple citizens, okay? Multiple, yes. Applicants, he will scrutinize the plans. So at the time, you need to, this one you need to maintain. You know, because when you open that inbox, you need to show all the plans, okay? What are all, he scrutinize all the plans, you need to show his inbox for a future reference and as well as for a further.
Okay.
So this is about the request info thing. Okay. So as well as the tenant how to set up, this is the thing. Okay. Any queries we have still now about how to configuring tenant? Are you clear? You people are clear, no?
Yes.
Yes.
And one more question: why in the master is not running? You have restricted from public access, or your internal you have some issues?
For what? UI or what?
UI 11.
No, UI level, we are not doing anything for EDC like for this, okay. Only for EDC dedicated, this repo we created, okay. So this only for a just like a service only we are providing, okay. This one, so that's why UI is not providing. Because we don't have any like inbox any kind, okay. For that is a portal, those thing is required. So as now, because it's a like a independent service, this one, okay.
Yes,
there's no dependence for this.
The login configuration is available, only the problem is it is not getting logged in. That's
yeah, you can, yeah, I think you can log in with the e-commerce user. Have you tried?
Yes, I have tried. The demo is a username, right? It's not getting logged in, that is a problem. It is automatically redirecting again to login,
yeah,
is success.
But some issue we faced and then it didn't work. That's fine. No, that's right. UI, we are not providing anything. So you cannot do anything in there from UI level. So UI, you can do only thing is like a city logo, something if you want to update, that you can, only you can do. Like a city logo, city information, those things from UI also you can do, okay. From backend,
okay,
as well, UI.
Whether it is not working from my machine or your machine, it is working, right?
No, it's not working. Now it's also, actually we faced some issue.
Okay.
So, but we thought like as of now, that UI is not required to provide any. So, only the water scrutinizing those things is working, and that is enough, they said. Okay, that's why I didn't work on that. Okay. No, if a really requirements, we will, because
no,
there's no use of that thing.
And just for
that's why we didn't work further. Fine, no issue on that one.
Okay.
So others is clear about how to set up a tenant, everything locally. See, locally also same only, okay, whatever you are doing.
Yes,
you know, to use the, like a ULB1, ULB2, Chennai. You can configure with the UIT also, like a chennai.egomans.org, or you can use any URL. It doesn't matter about that things. So, Vijay, you said no, your setup is done locally. You're able to scrutinize, no?
I didn't have any DXF files. Do you have any sample DXF files?
Yeah, we have that. Okay, we will mention that training panel I will mention later. Okay, you can download.
Okay.
So there I will provide the hyperlink.
Okay,
UOT hyperlink, that file, DXF file link I will provide.
Okay.
You just download from there, or otherwise I will send mail also.
Okay.
After the session.
Okay.
So any questions about that? Any further clarification required? Any part like that till now? Whatever we have been.
Okay.
Anyone else tried workspace setup other than Vijay?
Yes.
Vimal, your
yes.
voice is not audible.
Yeah. Yes, we have some important issue. We will clarify with Vijay.
Okay.
If
fine,
I have
fine.
Any questions,
so
then,
okay.
I will touch with you.
Okay. Sure. Okay, so in the vendor's machine also it will work. Okay, no issue with that thing. Only
okay.
one thing is that everything we have repo, everything we configure from a setup done on the Linux machine only. Okay, so
okay.
only when you're taking the clone it and then just next to working on that, you may configure like a say like local workspace and all, it will work. One when only you will face issue like when you're pushing data to repo. Local changes, you want to push it to Git repo like that. Okay, so at the time only you'll face like a white space character some issue. So in like recently we faced like one of guy is like
okay.
when you're taking the pull from the repo, so locally just changes are getting merged. Okay,
in Windows
that
machine.
Is why because
in Windows machine, right?
Yeah, in this in a Windows machine.
Okay,
so at the time some confused, so white space character something getting adding. Okay, so when you're taking pull from the Linux which are configured in Linux machine, okay, that repo, so at the time when we're taking pull from Windows, so at the time white space character getting adding. Okay, so at the time, so all the changes getting merging automatically. Okay, even though you don't have any changes locally, so only
some
when you like do merge configure.
Yes, okay.
yeah. When you merge config or merge automated, when will happen? Because locally if you have changes already, changes the file and then at the time it will merge. Okay. But this case, even though you don't have local changes, still it will get merged. Okay. So you can configure that one. So, like you will show when terminal, if you check the git status, so
okay.
it will show some warning. With the warning, you just Google it and then they given some solution. You can follow that. You can get rid of that thing.
Okay, only the thing is in Windows machine, we need to install the Redis server manually.
Yeah, and one more is this Redis server. Okay, sometimes may not, that Redis server may not work. Okay, like so server is up, but still if the Redis server is not, so at the time you need to restart server. Sometimes server may not, so Wi-Fi may not start.
Okay,
due to the Redis server. So at the time you need to stop your Redis server and you need to restart it and then start your Wi-Fi. Then it will work.
Sure.
So in Ubuntu Linux machine is embedded. Okay. So we
okay.
are haven't faced any issue like our regard Redis or anything. But in the Windows machine you need to install. Okay. You need to download that one. You need to run separate manually. You need to run each and every time Redis server those things. So other than we haven't faced any issue other than that, just try it and then if you have any issues in Windows, just mail it us. Mail
okay.
it for us and we'll clarify on that things. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So this is about that. Till now we have been like local setup and tenant, how to set up in tenant, those things. Okay.
okay.
So next is a Flyway scripts and best practices. Okay.
okay.
So that you can do. So in the setup level, we have one file. Okay. Flyway. So this under DB migration main level you need to add, okay, your DDL DML, okay, those master data, those things you need to add under. Okay, so in the client IMP level, resources DB and then migration. Okay, so in the consent tenant you can add, or you can put it in a, so here you can create main, okay, one more folder also.
Okay,
like the script is common across the tenants, okay, across all the tenants. So those things you need to put it under this one, okay, main. So this is a Jupyter MapQuery, state is a stay that schema city specific scripts. Okay,
okay,
this main nothing but it is common for all, okay, like that adding any detail, okay, those things is common for all. So all the time this in other time folder only you need to add your scripts, okay, detail script, those things.
Okay,
so now I created an one more header. So okay, so we have to, you have to follow some naming convention, okay,
okay,
for this flyway schema scripts. Okay, so we is the version, that one thing, and then this is a timestamp. Okay,
okay,
this is a timestamp. Okay, so this is a year, like 2020, and then this is a month. Okay, okay, a year followed by month followed by date, okay, current date. And so short way, you should keep always the current date, okay, when you are committing any new script, you want to add any new script. So at the time with whatever your, so at the time working on that, the day only you need to run, I mean you need to add that times day timestamp. Okay, so date, so and then it is a hour, minute, seconds. Okay, so like 12 12 13 30 seconds. So and then, so this is the module name. Okay, EGA is nothing but module name, so you can keep as a EDCR occupancy master data, something you get. Okay, to identify DML DDL you can add the text also, and then the file should end with a .sql. okay, so just it will add. So just add it to your script. Okay, so and then you need to start the server. Okay, so in the production and all, should it may fail. Okay, if suppose the stamps is, suppose if you add additionally one more, okay, so in the production environment or UAT may run. Okay, it may fail in the production environments. Okay, and one more is, this is a one time only. Okay, you cannot modify the files once you commit that, so it's a little bit difficult things. Okay, this script here you need to very careful on that, particularly when you're committing in a script. Before the committing you need to test locally. Okay, you need to commit locally, so I mean add it and locally start the server, check whether that file is executing or not. Okay, suppose if anything is failed, script is failing, then locally you will get the error. Okay, so what reason it is failing. Okay, that one thing. Next is that's what here, the timestamp only, and the next is, so after the timestamp and the module between two under double slash underscores. Okay, it's a two underscores.
Okay,
yeah, so remaining under separation you can use one double one underscore, you can use that. Yes, okay, only important. Okay, so because based on the timestamp only it will run. Okay, that flyway, based on the timestamp only, your script will be get executed. Okay, so once it's executed, it will put it in a, so how to check what are the script is executed. Okay, so that you can check in the schema version. So sorry, flyway schema version, flyway schema history. Okay, so order by ID descending order 10. So this is the thing. Okay, here it will show what are the scripts are executed. Okay, what are the script files are executed. So this is a version. Okay, this is a version. The description will come. So this should be unique. Okay, and one more is this version, that timestamp should be unique. Okay, you should not give duplicate. So it should be unique. Okay, you, the description you can keep a duplicate also. See here, you can use, no, it is your occupancy master data. You can use multiple time also. Okay, but that timestamp should unity change according to that current date when you are modifying, when you are committing. So that only one makes, so that's a locally, if you run it will show error like. So other should be unique, and then that should have the, it should not add any additional.
Okay.
Like this timestamp should be with a date, month, year, sorry, year, month, year, date, and then hours, minutes, seconds. Okay, so in this standard you need to follow that one thing. And then so
any other like city table you need to configure.
Yeah, city data you need to configure. So that's what, that yeah, you can put masters. It here.
Any other masters like city?
So one is the city you need to configure. That was first one. Okay, okay, next is like that. No other things. Okay, like if you want to change, you can, you have to that occupancy, those things you need to update. Next is your occupancy master. Okay.
Okay.
That is according to that your city, what are the occupancies you have. That is a city data. Next is occupancy data. Okay, so that occupancy table, so the DCR application detail will save in a EDCR application detail. Okay, this is the table name, EDCR application. This is the main application. Okay, so it inside, so here it will show only the application information only. So like application number, status, those thing only it will show. So the DXF file, report file, those IDs it will save in one more EDCR application detail. So here application detail, where application is equal to one. So this is a, so here it will say your DXF file ID reference. And this is your scrutinized. And one more is, this is a plan detail file store. Okay, so I have said no, we are converting into, we are serializing into JSON. Okay,
yes,
that plan detail we are serializing into JSON, and that file we are saving in a file, text file, that ID we are mapping it. Okay, this status is supported, that's why
where the file is stored will happen.
Okay, so next is file store your locally. So in home directory, home directory, or you can in your C folder. Okay, if in this Windows machine in your C folder it will create, or you can view that manual location also, like so ego file store. So one folder will be created. Okay, when you first starting that, one folder which will be ego file store, one folder it will create locally in your local machine. Okay, so next is when you configure that, so this is nothing but your city code. Okay, for each city, whatever code you share, no, you configure.
Yes.
So with that city code, it will, the folder will be created. Okay. So nothing but you was here. I shown, no, you updated. So actually, it maybe in start on the start server it may not create. So when you upload any file, so at the time it will check whether the folder present or not. If the folder is there, it will use, it will push into that folder. Otherwise, it will create new folder. Okay.
If you want to change the path of the folder,
okay. So that you need to configure na, there only. The application config properties we have. Okay.
Okay.
So here, file store base directory.
Okay.
So here the file store base directory you give. So where is it? Okay, in your suppose if you are in a Windows machine, if you are putting in a D folder, okay, D drive or E drive. Okay, so that location E drive / ego file store. You create one folder like ego file store, but naming should have that one only. In our structure only.
Okay.
But you can just, you can give like a base directory, you can say give as a D drive. Okay. Under the D drive, it will create one more folder, ego file store. So default is it will use the current directory, okay, wherever the server is running. Okay, there in the current directory, it will take it. Or other, you can give this file store base directory path also, you can give. So in the under that folder, it will get, it will look. Okay, so and one more. So under that it will create like this. Okay, folder, all the files will be stored in here. So this is so under PB, so it's nothing but your, it's a state code. Okay, like here PB is nothing but Punjab here. Okay, so like the TN, it will create one more folder like a TN. So under the digit digger is a module name. Okay,
okay.
Digit digger is a module name. So this is the thing. Okay.
Okay.
This is the serial. It's the serial. Convert in a JSON format is saved. Okay.
Okay.
It's not a Java serialization, we are converting into JSON.
Okay, okay.
Okay, it is saved in a JSON format, this file. And then this file,
we are saving JSON format. Instead of saving the files, we are saving the JSON
format.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. No, no, this content is a JSON format. But we are saving the text format only. You can change, okay. That if you want, you can change it also.
No, but it won't affect anything, right? It's in, let it be in text only.
It won't affect anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. And then one more about the migration, Flavia migration, okay.
Okay.
So this is the things, okay. So here that the migration, when you enable true, so it is a whether the scripts need to execute or not, okay. DB migration enable means it will execute all the scripts, okay. So default it is true, it should be true only, okay. Then only whatever you come adding the file, those will be get executed. Otherwise, it won't get executed. Okay.
Okay.
So next is a flyway validation migrate. Okay. So this is like the file if you are modifying. Okay, an existing file you already committed.
Okay.
Whether do you want to validate this existing modified file? Okay. This newly, so here I have committed this file already. If suppose if you're adding one more script, okay, so at the time do you want to execute this file also? Okay, we are asking. Okay, so default it, if it is false, it won't execute. In the existing file, if you are doing any modification, then it won't run. Okay, only new file only it will get executed with this one only. Try migration enable. So if you want to execute the modified file also, then you need to this one, you need to enable. Okay, true.
Okay.
Validation migration. But you may face issues like a checksum issue. Okay. So this file is already executed. Okay. Now you have done changes. So because here with the version, okay.
Okay, therefore the
DB level audit,
it is trying to execute the entire file, right?
Yeah. So entry is in the database level, the schema history, flyway schema history, they are already entities there. Okay. So they are based on that history, schema history, based on that only this script will get executed. Okay. So at that time when you enable that the validation you found enable means, so at that time it will try to execute again this one. So if you try to execute again means these scripts also it will execute.
Then
okay, so at the time you need to write reverse scripts. Okay, you need to write reverse scripts. Okay, you need to revert that existing whatever changes is there. So but that's in this case only your face issue, and one more is you need a schema history level, you need to delete that entry also, then only it will execute. Otherwise you will get checksum issue. Okay, so with the schema version, checksum is already entries there, so issue you will get. So this checksum issue for this version, on checksum it will generate. So normally you won't prefer to add modifying the file. Okay, just add it new file instead of modifying existing file, add it in new file, revert delete the existing data. If you want to add any new things on the based on the existing only, so at that time just write the reverse script and then add the your new data, insert the fresh data. So at that time it will automatically.
Okay.
So this enable and then migration repair is that file name, like if you want to files anything you will be modifying at the time, it is also should be true. So that checksum, do you want to anything to repair? Okay, so this is about that schema, that migration, DB migration things. Okay, so other than no need to anything, and one more is you need to use this common domain name. Okay. So this common domain name you can add it here also. Okay, so common domain name you need to, suppose if you're,
yes, if I want to override the common domain name, I need to override here also.
Yeah. So here the common domain, yeah, like we are using egovernments.org for all the URL, like a domain subdomains, what is a common domain? Okay, like that.
Okay.
For that you need to give here. Okay, in US. What are you giving? That's why we are giving the common domain name. Egovernments.org is the default one. Okay. So here you can use like if you use the tn.n.org something.
Okay.
That you give as a common domain name, and then with that you change with the city name. Okay. So this is about a flyway schema history, state and city specific. Yeah, okay. That negation is required. Pradeep. Pradeep, are you there?
Yeah, we know. Yeah.
This one, authentication and whitelisting of URLs.
Okay. Yeah. See, internally in the servers, when we are opening the auth tokens, right, any tokenization, so that you have anything to explain?
No, actually, as a, we are not enabled, no, that auth token thing.
But can we give some idea, actually, how it works or overall concept? If they want, they will enable it later.
Okay.
Okay, as of now, this is open API. If you want to enable the authentication, you can enable.
Authentication, OAuth authentication. Actually, we added OAuth authentication, but we disabled. Okay.
The point is, sometimes it's normally it's an internal service. Okay, it's like you are not exposing it to the external world. Whatever the services, right? It is you are running on top of the existing server. So from that server to server, it's an internal call actually. You no need of auth tokens, all those things, frankly saying. It's because you're not exposing the directly URL to the external world. It's internally, it's an internal call and you're scrutinizing and you're giving the output to the end of the your application actually.
Correct.
But if even required, but so we have some option actually, auth tokens, all those funda. So you can whitelist few set of URLs. Only from that it can receive the request. Those kind of some settings are there. That we try to do through this authentications, auth tokens, all those things.
Okay.
So that's a code wise we have that. Just we need to enable it and we need to work on that actually. Because as a training session, we are just explaining you guys. Tomorrow when you are integrating, if you want to whitelist or maybe in security audit comes, if you want anything to whitelist those cases, you can use those features.
Okay. The code level where we need to configure this, what?
That will give some idea. So, we'll just explain how it works or one or two configurations you need to do, nothing else. So, somewhere you need to whitelist that IP and that kind of configurations only.
Okay.
You know, just show where we need to configure that, that's sufficient.
No, that is a master level we have that changes.
Okay.
It, no, but we have to do that thing. Pradeep?
Yeah, yeah. No, my
we need to take call, no?
No, that whitelisting, we have some configuration, right? That is there now?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that code is available. Okay.
That you just show the code where it is. They will do it later.
Okay. So for that APIs, we have implemented OAuth authentication, OAuth 2 authentication, okay. So currently we are using the internal only, internal call only we are doing. So because we are internal, our system only are calling, that's why we, as of now, we are not enabled, okay. So, but when you enable, so the how it is looking, this is a thing, okay. This is the first API we have written, okay. It is your OAuth, okay. So you need to pass the tenant ID. So this is a Spring API only, okay. So the Spring OAuth API only, this one, defaultly available only. So we haven't configured any additional, okay. This
Okay, this will return the OAuth token. We need to pass into the every URL, right?
Yeah, yeah, that's correct. So whenever you're making request, so once we enable this thing, okay, in future we enable this authentication base, okay. So at the time you need to pass the this OAuth.
We know anything else is left today?
No, probably almost completed only. So. Only this thing only, authentication, whitelisting, and next is a production server requirements overview is here.
Okay.
That one thing. And the next one I need to look with that core is there, there is something. I already explained few things.
Yes, already you have explained these things.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, only few things require this. I need to explain about the that common the database those things. Okay, where it is? What is the occupancy? Those things.
Yes.
Database tables I have to show.
Yes, show those things.
Those things only. Okay, so just I will show the thing and then you'll take this one. So you can check, go to here, okay, in the schema. Then actually in future this much table woman we have simplified version, but this not yet released. Okay, once we release around on some 30 tables only it will come. Some all unnecessary tables we have removed. So later if you may not know. Okay, so you can EDCR tables which are starting with EDCR, okay, all are related with EDCR. Okay, so this is application detail. Okay, application detail, this comparison that we are showing here. Okay, so and then that PDF we are generating some PDFs. Okay, plant PDF, I have explained. No, so like the DXML we are converting to PDF format. Okay, that we have there is floor plan, section plan, everything. Okay, each floor plans and then the parking plan, those PDF detail will be saved here.
Okay,
so that's it. So only this thing, this plan info, plan rule, rules, rule, this is not using. Okay, only that 3-4 tables only, these 4 table only as of now. Currently use.
Okay, but occupancy and all,
so occupancy, this is of the tables. Okay, AGBP occupancy, this EGBP sub occupancy, EGBP usage, and then EGDCR sub feature color code. So these are the 4 tables. Okay, this feature I explained, no, like the color code how we are mapping for each feature, like to identify the length of the gate, width of the gate, like that.
Sorry, sir.
So this occupancy or sub occupancy usages. Okay, so here you can configure. So you have to decide your occupancies. Okay, so after that you need to update your whatever your occupancies there, you need to update. Okay, here, and then what is the color code for that? Okay, that thing you need to update here. Okay, in these tables. And you code keep as it is. Okay, code we have, we use some standard only. Some places, that's what, some place if your existing, if you look that some places are based on the code we have, so because this description may change. Okay, one of the city, but that's why code we get defined as a standard. Okay, for this, so description you can change it. So some places like based on the occupancy type, particular occupancy you need to validate. Okay, these are, so at that time you need to check this occupancy check also. So at that time we are using the code only, mostly we are using code, so we are not using this name and all. So at the time, so because the code will be standard things only, even the description change also doesn't matter for us. So that's why we are mostly the based on code only we will use code level. That only. So in this is the occupancy table. Okay, here you can update your things. And then this is a sub occupancy. Okay, here with that, what is the parent occupancy? It will be mapped. And then for each occupancy, what are the sub occupancy? And then if it's color code, if it is there, it will map. Otherwise, it's not a mandate. For sub occupancy, so for main occupancy, color code is Mandatory only if you have any, if you don't have any rule values based on a sub-occupancy, okay, sub-occupancy or usages, okay, if you don't have any rule validation, so at the time for a main occupancy, color code is mandatory. If suppose if you don't have like all tools are based on the sub-occupancy, if you have validation, so at the time you define color code at sub-occupancy level, no need to define at main occupancy level, okay. So that's why you can see here, okay, we see for a few occupancies we haven't defined color codes. See, okay. So why we are having defined? Because so based on main occupancy we don't have any rule, like so for each sub occupancy we have separate rules, so that's why we have defined for a sub occupancy color code. So that's why for main occupancy we haven't any color code, but in this cases for main occupancy only the rules are there, so that's why we have different rules for a main occupancy color code. So for a sub-occupancy usages, color code is for all. See, not only for this. So for all, the color code should be mandatory only if you have any rule validation. Okay. So for which occupancy you have rule validation, for those only you update color code. For remaining are not required. Okay. So That's it about this occupancy switches, and then this is the color code thing, that feature color code mapping. So in this, okay, like interior open space, this the habitable room, that color code is a 4. So under interior open space, how to identify a habitable room? So using the color code 4, we are identifying. So and then floor, exterior wall, we are using the 5 color code, okay. So this thing also you can change it. So this color codes and all you can change, okay?
Okay.
This color codes and all is not as you can change. TV level, this color code is configurable. So as per your account, you can change it.
See, the point is it is, the meaning is not like that you can change anytime, okay? Once you provided one color code, it's before you start the project, this is configurable. Okay, later if you do any changes, it changes the entire meaning actually. Example, when you're giving 25 as residential, you're running your project for 6 months, later you change it to 30, it won't work out. The reason is for old diagrams, it's still looking 25 only, right? When you're submitting tomorrow. So, but later if everyone is following the new color coding, then it is fine.
Okay. Before we need to configure.
Yeah, so it's a standard, okay. First, we need to finalize what is the color code. We already defined something. Whether it is correct or not, is it sufficient? Because bylaws say something sometimes. In the local bylaws also says, okay, you need to use this set of color codes for some few things. Example, boundary should be like this, those kind of things. Also, one more thing is we are not dependent on the color code all the time, okay. So only wherever we are extracting the area, those cases, it is required. And functionality wise, like dimension, those cases, we need color coding to identify in case of compound wall, front compound, back compound height, to identify in the same layer, we are using different color code to define the length, width, those cases. So that we need to, let's say anyway, standard, I don't think you will change it multiple times, but we have option actually, it is not like it don't support. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's it about these things. The tables, just a few tables only. I don't have much tables. Okay, so we still go for this authentication whitelisting of URL.
That is you showed, right? Anything else other than that?
Code I haven't shown. Code, no. But they actually they need to configure that URL.
That's okay. Okay. Other than that, you explained all these parameters, right? Almost. Yeah.
Yeah. These are request parameter. Everything I explained.
That's
so good. That's what. And one more is I explained with that state name is mandatory. Okay, then request they're sending tenant ID. So for Tamil Nadu, TN dot Chennai, TN dot Trichy, like that. They have to pass. That's the standard. I said like that only. Currently, we are a PB using, no, like that only.
Correct. So anyway, that configuration at state level, code also, right?
Yeah. Code. I explained that one also. In the state correct. City code, we need to update that state name. Whatever. Okay. One more is for tables, how the it will state name it will pick. Okay. So here you need to config client ID we have. Okay. This is nothing but your state name. So like Tamil Nadu. Okay. So this state name mode it will pick. So in this IMP level, so feature state level you need overriding. So here you given Tamil Nadu, no? So based on this client ID, it will pick the state file.
And also this should be there in your name of the EGCT table of the state schema.
Actually, we are not using for to pick the beans. We are not using that. So we are using this client ID only from property file. We are reading the client ID to read the state name.
State name.
Only the state name. So remaining all from city, EG city only. City information we are getting. So only the state name we are getting from, okay, this client ID. So remaining all that for a city information, like a district code, those things like ULB, okay, those things are we are reading from a EG city table only. Okay. So that here if you convey, then only it will pick your state file, otherwise it won't pick. Okay. So in this override properties file, you need to add, okay, this one also. Client ID also you need to configure it. It's a first, okay. Okay, so
that's it, you know.
So yeah, any queries? Yeah.
Because I'll explain briefly about server requirements also.
Sorry. Hello.
Yes.
Any queries you have, your people?
No.
Fine. No, everything. Huh?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, but you can continue.
One more time, just. That's the last topic, right? Anything else other than that?
No problem. Only it. No,
okay.
Only the queries in it. I explain mostly.
Got it.
Okay.
Can see my screen?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. How we structured is we are using Apache and internally we have a Wildfly 11 actually, right? This is our application service. We have internally Redis is required, 3, and 5-store system is NFS. We configured as of now, NFS 5-store. We are using Postgres. Elasticsearch we disabled as of now. If required, you can enable that flag actually. We have a flag called Elasticsearch is required or not. The reason is, if you enable it, what we can do is you need to install your Elasticsearch also, so that we can push all these records to the how many applications coming in each city, all those things, tracking and reporting is easy. That's the main reason.
Okay.
So these are the major things. Okay, when we are deploying to production. So this is some standard we used actually. Normally we have a load balancer, we have a application servers. Normally in our Koi code instance, we are using 2 servers, 1 Elasticsearch, 1 database, and 1 NFS. So 5 servers we are expecting, and this is the size actually. Okay, the database NFS we need to increase more actually. It is 100 GB is not sufficient. It should be in terabytes. Okay, it depends on the file size, all those things. See, the application server also is, as of now, we added 2. It depends on the load balancing, the number of transactions happens, all those things we can manage. Okay, So at least these VMs required were, this is the configuration we used in STC. The same configuration we are using in KoiCode in other places also. Okay. So there's nothing difference actually, how we are looking locally, right? Similarly, only thing is load balancing, one extra thing is there. Apache and servers, based on the requirement, you can increase. It's your local machine, it is like your Wildfly, Elasticsearch, database, and NFS. These are the configurations required at the SDC level. Okay, so only problem is it needs certification. So it will go through audit, and audit version, whatever is there, right? So we need to get the certification, then only we'll allow you to open that. So this is the basic requirements of setting up of in production environment. You can create the same thing for UAT, and you can use it for testing purpose actually. And the same you can copy for production. As Vinod said, in the override.properties, you just need to, that's the file, major file where they're configuring all these basic things. Okay. Other than that, you create your own branch, all those things he explained, and you create your Jenkins setup so that you can deploy it easily every time when you are ready. Fine?
It's fine.
Yeah. So this is overall flow actually we explained. Any suggestions, any questions are there, please update in the tweet, and we'll take one more call and we'll fire. We'll discuss. In that sheet, anything is shared, you know?
Yeah, I can put it on. Whatever the place the question. Some 5 queries raised there, so I explain on.
Okay, no issue. Okay.
I have any queries during the implementation,
also
I can ask, right?
Yes, okay. Yes. So we'll help you guys, don't worry. You start the work, you see only as a, say what you feel actually, I need the frank feedback from you guys actually, whether, what do you think, is it so easy or it's so difficult? So what's your opinion? How you feel actually, is it easy to develop?
Yes, it is easy to develop, but we need to analyze each and every features. If the feature is difficult, it means we can overwrite it. The rule is changing, you can easily override the rules. But only thing is, each and every feature we need to well understand.
See, that's the reason when in the first day, why I included all the develop process, the same reason. So if they gave proper template format data, developers work is easy. Okay. That's why we are trying to do feature wise also, the rule extraction. We are not going with any occupancy or any other. There are different formats you can do, okay? But why we are giving feature-wise is, developers, it's damn easy, actually. Just, if you want any parking, everything is in one place. Code the parking path, everything, and you test it. And we are not covered all the unit cases in few places, but try to add that logic also based on your requirement. So if you add more and more use cases, test use cases, it is easy, just because every build it will check anything is failing, because it's keep on changing the code actually, right? Yes. It will be useful actually. So when you are planning, you just plan accordingly with your development effort also.
Sure.
Okay.
Okay.
And the same way, the reporting formats also. What we provided is a default reporting format. If you want to change it to your own formats, it will be well. It will be good actually.
Yes.
Okay. And also it includes your integration part, that also you need to plan how to do that, and how to show these values. Try to make use of the same thing actually by calling the same APIs. Okay. Don't see, if you're not auto populating the drawing parameters in the existing application, it's of no use.
Yes, correct.
Okay. So try to auto populate. Yeah. And make them to make it existing fields read-only, so that they no need to enter and modify something.
Yes.
Otherwise, what happens, whatever you did this entire work, right, it's of no use. right? Yes, the plan says something. If they modify something in the application form, it's not correct. So you just take the existing application also how it is there, and you suggest based on that what are the parameters you are providing so that you, they can make the existing fields as read only or something.
Okay.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Let's see, guys. So, so when you guys are going to start this development? Any plan?
Already started developing layout approval.
Layout approval?
Yes, already we have started.
What is the layout approval you are doing? You are doing just application submission?
Yes, application submission.
You are using any drawing for that?
No, no, there is no scrutiny.
Okay.
Just something the layout drawing.
As oh, they want?
Yes.
Okay. They want that feature also?
Yes, yes.
Okay, okay, okay.
Now only we have started to design. Apparently we need to start the scrutiny.
But are you guys using their existing application or you have your own application for this layout approval?
Layout approval we are going to do first.
Why you guys are not using Digit platform?
That is a management decision. Because
another point is you're developing some new features or new functionalities.
Yes. Yes.
But you are doing your own things actually, like freshly you are preparing a new project actually. From scratch you are writing, right? If I am not wrong.
Yes. Yes, correct.
You already have any application similar to this? Or you are just using that application you are modifying or something?
No. We are going to develop a fresh one. We are not having any existing applications.
Okay, it's management decision. Okay.
Only see, we don't have any resources or developers in the React.js.
Okay.
For the front end only.
Mm-hmm.
For the back end, we know all still MVC and REST API and all. We have the experience.
Okay, that's the main reason.
Yes, that's the main reason they are thinking, but I need to discuss with management people.
Okay. See, the point is, see, writing from scratch, it takes its own time actually. And
yes,
some feature which is already, example, if my out of that project, if you have 40-50% already covered, because for you need entire thing, authentication, authorization from that point to bank integration, online payment, everything, till end to end, the workflows, everything, right? And citizen portal, everything you need to write from scratch. But if you use the existing module, which gives you all these default functionalities, on top of that, you just need to modify a few things, then it is easy.
It is easy only. I need to discuss with because from the scratch, instead of developing from the scratch, we can use existing application, we can easily modify the client task, we can easily modify the.
Yeah, it's just a suggestion. You just check once. It's their call actually. Yeah.
Sure.
Hi, Omka.
Hi, Pradeep.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Yeah, it's today's end actually. We completed almost. It's a third day. So it's just almost. We are just closing this actually.
Right. So I wanted to check from the IntelliSense team. Any general feedback? Do you guys know everything you need to begin work?
Yes, Omkar.
Infra and code setup and how do you do stuff for EDCR? You guys are comfortable?
Yes, yes, comfortable only. At the time of implementation, if I have any doubts,
Okay. So any high level plan which has been put up, I have requested Murugan also to share. But next three milestones, what are you guys trying to achieve?
That I need to discuss with Murugan also.
Okay. You're not aware. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. I will talk to Murugan then. Okay.
Sure.
That's it from my side.
Yeah, thanks, Omka. Thanks, guys. Then we'll wrap up. You know?
Yes.
Yeah, Pradeep. So okay. They don't have any query, you can wrap up.
So thanks, Vinod, for conducting this. Sir. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Omkar. Thanks.
Thanks, Vinod.
You know.
And
thank you, guys.
Hi,
this
is Bala, and my special thanks to the whole Digit team. I think it's been very well planned and the way it was developed. So people from other backgrounds were. I'm from the Django Python, so it might take some time, but as you just explained a little while ago, you know, the most of the features expected are already done. So it's, most of the modules are reusable, except for that we have to code a bit, but great work by the whole team. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Vana.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Please just call us if you have any issues or anything. So Igor will help you guys to implement this. But we'll find us a proper channel actually where to file if you have any queries. Okay, so we'll formulate all this properly. Then we'll go ahead.
Sure.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.